Well, straight away, we're starting with a big Times Now exclusive. Paramveer Singh speaks to Times Now. The former police commissioner of Mumbai, in fact, sticks to his claim. And he says that the letter to Maharashtra Chief Minister was sent from his own email ID. Also, in fact, this is the confirmation of sorts from former Mumbai Police Commissioner Paramveer Singh that he has informed Maharashtra Chief Minister Uddhav Thackeray it was sent from his own email ID.
Hello.
Hi, sir. Sir, just wanted to ask you, your letter has created quite a bit of a controversy. Wanted to know, what is your next step right now? Are you planning to actually go ahead with this in court?
With this what?
Are you planning to go to court with this, sir?
No,
I just wanted to know what your next plan would be.
Whatever I have to say, I brought it to notice the government, that's all.
Sir, you said in that letter that you had spoken to Uddhav Thackeray and Sharad Pawar regarding this.
I'll go for the comments to make, Kajal. No further comments.
Sir, it's a very important this thing, so would like to know.
Thank
if...
you.
Okay, sir. Okay.
I can only confirm that email ID is mine only.
Okay, sir. Hello.
Yeah,
Kajal. Hi, sir. Sir, just wanted to ask you, your letter has created quite a bit of a controversy. Wanted to know, what is your next step right now? Are you planning to actually go ahead with this in court?
With this what?
Are you planning to go to court with this, sir? No, I just wanted to know what your next plan would be.
Whatever I have to say, I brought it to notice the government, that's all right.
Sir, you said in that letter that you had spoken to Uddhav Thackeray and Sharad Pawar regarding this.
I'll go for the comments to make, Kajal. No further comments.
Sir, it's a very important this thing, so would like to know.
Thank you.
Okay, sir. Okay.
I can only confirm that email ID is mine only.
Okay, sir.
Well, let's go across to our reporters now. Mumbai Bureau Chief Kajal Iyer is joining me from outside Paramveer Singh's residence. And we also have Rakesh Trivedi reporting on the story from the BJP's camp. And my colleague Mohit Bhatt is outside Sharad Pawar's residence here in the capital. But I want to begin with you, Kajal. That is a super exclusive Paramveer Singh speaking to you on phone. Although he refused to expand on his plan from here on. But the fact of the matter is that this is a solid confirmation that he did send that letter to the Chief Minister and the Governor of Maharashtra from his own email ID. And there are very important details in that letter on what sort of pressure was the police force working under coming directly from the Home Minister of the state.
Yes, in fact, statement from the CMO yesterday about it being unsigned was a way to divert, because there was a signed copy that was being sent, a physical copy that was being sent to the Chief Minister. In any case, the letter that we had, of course, was the email copy. And Paramveer Singh now confirming very clearly, categorically, that the contents of the letter are written by him. It was his letter that was sent, and that email ID is also his. So he did not want to expand on the comments, of course, right? Like you rightly pointed out, because very likely his lawyers have advised him not to speak about it, because yesterday in his defense, Anil Deshmukh even said that he will go ahead with a defamation suit. Not just that, an officer like Paramveer Singh would probably use the official channels to take this further, because he's already written to not just the Chief Minister but also the Governor, and any further response on this he would probably give once any of those authorities seek any confirmation or any elaboration from him.
Right. And in fact, we are getting some more breaking inputs coming in. Before I go across to our other reporters, I want to play this out for our viewers. What we are picking up is that the Maharashtra ATS has arrested two individuals in Mansukh Hiren's death case. Two people have been arrested in the recent development in terms of Mansukh Hiren's death case is concerned. For more on this, let me go across to Rakesh. Rakesh, who are these two people? Have they been identified by Maharashtra ATS? Can you share more details?
ये चोरों की सरकार है,
आगे उसका सरदार है।
ये चोरों की सरकार है,
आगे उसका सरदार है।
राकेश, कैन यू हियर मी?
Yeah, I can hear you. In fact, I'll show you the visuals that the BJP leaders and their volunteers have gathered here outside Dadra railway station, and they've been protesting now. The BJP, which was labeling allegation only against Shiv Sena earlier, but now is getting aggressive on the resignation of Anil Deshmukh as well. I have some senior leaders of BJP here. I will take you straight to them. Sir, what do you have to say on this entire episode?
देखिए, ये चोरों की सरकार है और उसके सरकार के सरदार उद्धव ठाकरे हैं। विधानसभा में माननीय विरोधी पक्ष नेते और हमारे नेता देवेंद्र फडणवीस जी ने उंगली उठाकर अनिल देशमुख को बताया था कि जिस प्रकार से आप सचिन वाजे को बचा रहे हैं और जिस प्रकार आप मुंबई पुलिस की हुई गलतियों को छुपा रहे हैं, ये स्पष्ट बात है कि आप भी इसके अंदर शामिल हो सकते हैं, ऐसी हमारी शंका है। और वो शंका परमवीर सिंह, मुंबई पुलिस कमिश्नर तत्कालीन, ने मुख्यमंत्री जी को पत्र देकर के साबित किया है कि ये चोरों की सरकार है, ये वसूली सरकार है, ये महावसूली आघाड़ी है। और इसलिए आज भारतीय जनता पार्टी हमारे सभी प्रदेश के नेतृत्व के निर्देश अनुसार सारे महाराष्ट्र में इस प्रकार का एक आंदोलन चलाएगी। और अनिल देशमुख को सरकार में रहने का अधिकार नहीं है, उसने राजीनामा देना चाहिए या मुख्यमंत्री ने उसका राजीनामा लेना चाहिए, इसके लिए यह कार्यक्रम सब जगह पे आया।
योगेश ठाकुर जी, मैं आपसे एक सवाल और पूछना चाहूंगा कि यहाँ पर बचाव में अनिल देशमुख ने कहा है कि क्योंकि जो जांच की आंच है वो परमबीर सिंह तक पहुंचने वाली थी, वो भी इस मामले में जो है कहीं ना कहीं शिकंजे में आ सकते थे, इसीलिए उन्होंने ये आरोप लगाया। तो पहला सवाल ये कि क्या NIA को परमबीर सिंह से भी जाँच करनी चाहिए और इस लेटर के अंदर जो आरोप है उसकी भी जाँच होनी चाहिए? दूसरा, क्या ये मामला सिर्फ अनिल देशमुख तक सीमित है या आगे और भी कोई बड़े पॉलिटिकल मास्टर्स इसमें है? आप इस पर क्या आरोप लगाएंगे?
देखिए, NIA अपनी निष्पक्ष तपास कर रही है। अगर परमवीर सिंह इसके अंदर शामिल है तो परमवीर सिंह के सामने भी इंक्वायरी होनी चाहिए। लेकिन मुंबई पुलिस कमिश्नर ने इस प्रकार के आरोप किसी गृह मंत्री पर किया होगा, ऐसे देश के इतिहास में और महाराष्ट्र के इतिहास में ये पहली घटना है। और उसने चैट के सारे एविडेंस दिए, इनको एविडेंस गिनते हुए सबसे पहले ये जाँच अगर निष्पक्ष होनी चाहिए तो अनिल देशमुख ने राजीनामा देना चाहिए ताकि जांच निष्पक्ष तरीके से हो सके। और अगर सारे तपास के बाद कोई भी दोषी आता है तो उस पर कार्रवाई करनी चाहिए। लेकिन आज ये मांग अनिल देशमुख के राजीनामा के साथ संबंधित है। अगर मुख्यमंत्री राजीनामा नहीं लेते हैं तो ये शंका मजबूत होती है कि शिवसेना और राष्ट्रवादी कांग्रेस ने सचिन वाजे को कलेक्टर के नाते पुलिस दल में वापस लिया था।
सो हियर बीजेपी MLA योगेश सागर एंड द अदर बीजेपी लीडर्स आर मेकिंग दिस एलिगेशन एंड डिमांडिंग दैट अनिल देशमुख मस्ट स्टेप डाउन, ही शुड रिजाइन, एंड द प्रोटेस्ट अक्रॉस द सिटी कंटिन्यूज।
राइट, एंड मोहित, यू आर रिपोर्टिंग फ्रॉम आउटसाइड शरद पवार्स रेजिडेंस एंड इट सीम्स दैट देयर विल बी सम NCP लीडर्स हु वुड वांट टू मीट हिम सून बिकॉज द प्रेशर ऑन अघाड़ी सरकार इज क्वाइट एविडेंट। अनिल देशमुख needs to resign if Uddhav Thackeray has to maintain the credibility of his government, and he can't take that decision without consulting Sharad Pawar.
Oh yes, and Preeti, you see, Sharad Pawar is like the adhesive who is holding on to this particular alliance of Mahavikas Aghadi, and all the major decisions are being taken by him. Now, we saw that 2 days ago, Anil Deshmukh, the Home Minister of Maharashtra, came at his residence, and when he came out after a 3-hour meeting, he said that he briefed Sharad Pawar about the Antila case and the death of Mansukh Hiran, and how there have been developments going on in Maharashtra, specifically in Mumbai. But after this letter bomb that Times Now has accessed, we know for a fact that how the pressure is mounting on the Mahavikas Aghadi to take some action against Anil Deshmukh, because Paramveer Singh till few days before was the chief police commissioner of Mumbai, and then he was shunted out, and then we saw that how Shiv Sena came in support of Paramveer Singh, while we saw that how the statements came in from Anil Deshmukh, which clearly gave a hint that he did not have the liking towards Paramveer Singh, and he said that for a fair investigation in Mansukh Hiran case he was shunted out. But now today what we expect is that later today Jayant Patil and Ajit Pawar are all set to land in Delhi. They'll be meeting Sharad Pawar at his residence. Sharad Pawar as of now is in Agra. He might come here in the afternoon, and in the evening a major and important meeting will take place, because the BJP is saying that the NCP led Home Department was acting as Mahavasuli Sarkar, and they are attacking Uddhav Thackeray also, that why no action has been taken. Remember, Preeti, few days ago Sharad Pawar met Uddhav Thackeray, and Uddhav Thackeray clearly blamed the NCP led Home Ministry for all the mess that is going on in Mumbai, and the senior officials of Mumbai Police were not so happy with the working of the Home Department, and hence All of this combined has mounted pressure on Sharad Pawar also, and a meeting has been called. We have to wait and watch what exactly will come out of this particular
meeting.
All right, stay with me,
Mohit. And in fact, as far as the pressure on Aghadi Sarkar is concerned, where there is a lot of criticism about the recent revelations from Paramveer Singh, from the union ministers as well, and Anurag Thakur has also demanded a probe in this entire matter. Listen to a reaction that has just come in.
These allegations showcases the level of corruption in Mumbai and in the entire state of Maharashtra under this Aghadi Sarkar. They have failed to check the COVID cases. The COVID cases are also on the rise. The corruption is also on the rise. The crime is also on the rise. What is Aghadi Sarkar doing? What is Mahagadi Sarkar doing? The CM must come out and speak and tell the country that what action he has taken.
Right. So another union minister there demanding a thorough probe into the entire incident, and of course calling the entire Mahavikas Aghadi Sarkar in Maharashtra corrupt, and the onus really lies with the chief minister of the state if he has to maintain the credibility of his government. Anil Deshmukh, clamor only growing right now for his resignation from several quarters, including some members of the Congress party also coming out and expressing openly that his position has become untenable following the revelations in that letter written by former Commissioner of Police of Mumbai, Paramveer Singh. And speaking to our reporter this morning, Paramveer Singh, in fact, has also confirmed that he has indeed sent that letter from his own email ID. Listen into some more reactions.
आज तो बहुत बड़ा प्रश्न चिन्ह खड़ा हो जाता है कि किस तरीके की एमवीए सरकार चला रहे हैं एमवीए। देखिए, इनके चहीते जो पुलिस अफसर थे, आज ये सब उनको ही गलत बता रहे हैं। गौरतलब है कि परमवीर सिंह इनके चहीते अफसर माने जाते थे, पुलिस कमिश्नर। अब किस तरीके से क्या गड़बड़ी हुई, क्या इस विफलता है इस सरकार की और गृह मंत्रालय की कि परमवीर सिंह जैसे अफसर को, अब जो इनके चहीते पसंदीदा थे, उनको बाहर निकाल दिया। फिर हाल ही में पूर्व मुख्यमंत्री आदरणीय देवेंद्र फडणवीस जी ने अपनी प्रेस वार्ता में बयान किया कि 2018 में किस तरीके से उनके ऊपर दबाव बनता था, कि वो भी शिवसेना का, कि आज के मुख्यमंत्री उनको उस जमाने में फ़ोन करके कहते थे कि इसे अफसर को रखो।
देखिए, बहुत गंभीर आरोप है। मुझे पहले तो कहना है कि जब वो पुलिस कमिश्नर थे तब उन्होंने ये बात क्यों नहीं बताई, इसे क्यों छुपाने की कोशिश की? जब उनका तबादला कर दिया गया तब वो ये चिट्ठी लिख रहे हैं। पहला बड़ा सवाल है, अगर वो कमिश्नर बने रहते तो शायद वो ये चिट्ठी ना लिखते। पुलिस पे बहुत शक और शुबा है, और कांग्रेस पार्टी की आला मर्यादाएं रखते हुए देशमुख साहब को फौरन इस्तीफा दे देना चाहिए। साथ साथ जो पुलिस ऑफिसर्स हैं उनको भी सस्पेंड करना चाहिए।
Well, there you go. In fact, the Congress party also demanding that Anil Deshmukh must resign because as he has been directly named by Paramveer Singh in his letter, the position of the Home Minister becomes very difficult. We are getting some more reactions coming in now. This one from Jayant Patil, who is seen backing Anil Deshmukh. NCP's Jayant Patil there lending support to his colleague and Maharashtra Home Minister Anil Deshmukh there.
खरं दोस्तो, या प्रसंगातून सुटण्याचा प्रत्येकाचे प्रयत्न वेगळ्या मार्गाने असतात।
महाराष्ट्र सरकारच्या प्रतिनिधीचं
असं आहे की वाजेंना एनआयएने ताब्यात घेतल्यानंतर त्याविषयी काही माहिती बाहेर आलेली आहे, ती प्रसारमाध्यमातून आपण सगळं देत आहात, आणि त्यावरून असं दिसतंय की पोलीस अधिकाऱ्यांचीच इन्व्हॉल्वमेंट होती। आमच्या सरकारने ठरवलं की कितीही मोठा अधिकारी असला तरी चालेल, पण अशा गोष्टी खपवून महाराष्ट्रात घ्यायच्या नाहीत, आणि त्यासाठी मुख्यमंत्री गृहमंत्री यांनी याचा पाठपुरावा करायचं ठरवल्यानंतर ही देण्यात आलेली प्रतिक्रिया आहे।
उत्तर दिलं, सॉरी थोडं ऑफेंडिंग आहे, पण वाजे यांनी
Well, let's go back to our reporters now. And Kajal, whether Anil Deshmukh gets support from his colleagues or from his alliance partners or not, at the end of the day, there is immense pressure on him. Do you know what is his plan today? Is he likely to give out any statement officially, really, on the revelations in that letter of Parambir Singh? Or what about the defamation case that he has promised to file against him?
We are waiting to hear from him whether there's going to be any official press conference, because so far he has only given out statements, and he has, according to his people, he has given a point-by-point rebuttal to Parambir asking why was he silent so far. Of course, Parambir in his defense can say that he had spoken to Uddhav Thackeray and Sharad Pawar at that moment, and there was nothing that was done further from there on. Anil Deshmukh has also said, like you said, that he will file a defamation suit against Parambir Singh, but so far we haven't heard from his office whether this defamation suit is going to be filed, drafted today or filed tomorrow. All of these things are still under the realm of possibility, and of course the pressure is very, very high. Ajit Pawar and Jayant Patil, they're trying to downplay the meeting with Sharad Pawar, saying that it was a pre-planned meeting, but clearly the discussion is whether Anil Deshmukh needs to go or not.
They can't turn a blind eye to the reality that's staring them in the face. For the moment, thanks very much, Kajal, Rakesh and Mohit, for getting us your inputs on the story. We're taking a quick break right now. Back in a moment with more news and updates.